I developed this interest by looking at my father, who's a chef. I won this competing with professional chefs who are twice my age, which makes it even more special. After looking at my live performance, everyone was speechless. In the month of October 2017, I started my own YouTube channel named Chef 5KU. Please do like, share and subscribe.
மெடல் வாங்கும் போது கூட என் கூட யாருமே இல்லை, ஏன்னா தனியாக நான் தனியாக போயிருந்தேன். அதனால் மெடல் இருக்கும்போது ஃபோட்டோ எடுக்க கூட அங்கே யாருமே இல்லை. ஸோ ஐ ரெக்வஸ்ட் அவர் கவர்மெண்ட் டு ஸ்பான்சர் அஸ், பிகாஸ் இங்கே இந்தியாலேயும் மிக திறமையான ஷெஃப்ஸ் அதிகமாக இருக்காங்க. ஸோ நீங்கள் ஸ்பான்சர் பண்ணிங்கன்னா ரியோ ஒலிம்பிக்ஸில் எந்த மாதிரி மெடல் வாங்குறாங்களோ அதை விட அதிகமாக எங்களால் வாங்கி காமிக்க முடியும் அப்படின்னு சொல்லி நான் தேங்க் பண்ணிக்கிறேன்.
ஹாய் எவ்ரிவான், வெல்கம் பேக் டு தி சேனல். So today we have Yashwant here, who's only 16 years old. In 120 years, he represented India and he made all of us proud. So let's all hear from Yashwant and let's all go ahead and ask him about his journey, how he has traveled so far these years and about the art of cooking. How did you get your interest towards cooking? How did this journey begin?
I started my culinary journey when I was just 9 years old. I developed this interest by looking at my father, who's a chef. He specializes in food cultures such as fruit carving, chocolate showpiece, sugar showpiece, etc. I observe my father very closely whenever he teaches his students, and I was amazed by looking at his wonderful art.
I think it's your gene. You've learned it from your father.
Yes.
And so far you have attended a lot of competitions. Which, by far now, which one is your most favorite and close to your heart and why?
The Culinary Olympics 2020 in Germany is my most favorite competition because I got a lot of friends from various countries. I learned many things.
And how was the feeling after attending the Olympics? How did you feel after winning 4 medals? Because you were the first one in 120 years to win 4 medals, right? How was it?
I felt very proud because this is the historic win for India in the history of last 120 years of Culinary Olympics. I won this competing with professional chefs who are twice my age, which makes it even more special. In fact, the senior chef said it's not 4 silver but 4 gold for my age in the meet. By looking at me, by looking at my age and me, no one believed that I'm competing in the Culinary Olympics. But after looking at my live performance, everyone was speechless and they appreciated me. The whole Indian chef fraternity is proud of this achievement and they celebrated it. It was an overwhelming response and appreciation from chef community.
You know, everybody is looking up to you now. You made India proud. And you made all of them proud by showing your skills. And what kind of preparations did you do before attending the Olympics?
I traveled to various countries to develop my skills on culinary arts. For example, I went to China in the month of November. I stayed over there for 30 days and learned the advanced sugar flour and fruit and vegetable carving.
So you are a specialist in fruit carving, right? So tell us about the art of fruit carving.
There are many varieties in fruit and vegetable carving, like Thai style, 3D work, floral estuary like that. But I do carving with a single knife, which is Thai knife.
What kind of information could be found there? When did you start it? Tell us about the history of your YouTube channel.
In the month of October 2017, I started my own YouTube channel named Chef 5KU. I have posted more than 180 videos, 100 videos of culinary artistry work, and the rest is the cooking videos. Till now, I have 20,000 subscribers.
So what kind of dishes do you normally cook, sweet or desserts? I mean, what is your style of
Actually, chefs usually specializes in areas like hot cooking, cold cooking, artistic work, pastry, baking, etc. But I want to be an all-rounder and I do all that.
That's definitely because being an all-rounder and everything, you know, you could learn a lot and you could be an expert in everything.
No, actually not like that. Even I am practicing and learning many things.
That's good, that's good. Because practice definitely makes a man perfect. Learning new things is not going to change, but you're just going to learn a lot. What would you like to be in your future? Do you have any dream or what? What are your future plans?
I want to become a celebrity chef with multiple skill sets. Further, I would like to establish a world-class culinary art studio to train the future celebrity chefs, corporate chefs, executive chefs.
I'm sure you'll be able to achieve it because you already achieved a lot in this age of 16.
Thank you.
And all the best for that. What would you like to tell to young minds who are watching this video? Any message you would like to tell to them?
My father always says that everyone is born with talent. Those who identify their talent and sharpen them become successful. So I tell everyone to find out their talent, voice out to their parents, and specialize in that.
So true, because finding what you are good at and working towards your passion is very, very important today, because you don't want to go into such field where you don't even know what you're doing and concentrate on that. You have a lot of, you have to attend competition. So how do you manage time?
My parents are very particular about my education. However, when they came to realize the dates of my board examination of my 10th standard and the culinary Olympics would overlap, my parents took a bold decision of dropping me from the school and admitted in a National Institute of Open Schooling, the largest open schooling in the world under Ministry of Education, Government of India. I completed my board examination in the month of October 2019. Then I traveled to China for my advanced skill development course on culinary arts. Then I returned back to India in the month of December 2019. By the time my results were also out, I scored 401 out of 500. Then I peacefully concentrated on my culinary Olympics, which held between 15th and 19th of October 2020 at Germany.
That's really great, because you were also able to score good marks and you even won the Olympics. If somebody is interested in cooking and have passion towards cooking, they wanted to be a chef, what do they have to do? Is there any particular course they should do to be a chef?
First, I prefer them to start with their regional or traditional cuisine, like which their mother and grandmother make at their home. And the second one is to be master in the culinary basics, which means the including knife skills, a knowledge about the ingredients, cuisine, etc.
Everything nowadays is available online on YouTube. You can just go ahead and learn many more new things. And if you want to move forward to advance, we can go and join culinary college. Thank you for sharing it. In this journey, which part of your life was most challenging?
My culinary journey, the culinary competition journey, the good and bad part. So let me first say about the bad one. The first challenge I face is the support. I have never got any support from state or central government. What I have spent so far has been from my father's hard-earned money. He spent a lot of money to develop my knowledge and skills. And also, South Indian Chef Association was being my backbone. They developed my skill by arranging culinary workshops. And a friend of my father, Chef Anand Ram from Singapore, he sponsored for my flight ticket. Other than that, we have never got any support from state or central government.
Mistakes happen, right? So if you have you ever made a mistake while doing it? If so, how do you manage to correct it?
It happens at the beginning, but when you start practicing for it, even though after starting, I've started practicing it, the mistakes happen. but slowly we can understand what is the logic in that, and we can able to resolve it.
Could you share a 2 minute dish, not Maggi, except for that, okay? Because Maggi can be done in 2 minutes.
Okay. The mine is the kids, not only for the kids, even the adults' favorite recipe, and even I have posted that in my YouTube channel. You can go and check through it.
Yeah, please go and check it out. We'll try to leave your link in the description. Thank you for being a part of this, Yashwin, making it a huge success, and coming here, sharing your stories. You're very inspirational, and the people watching this would love to hear from you. Viewers, if you're watching this, if you like this video and would want more content like this, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. And please do turn on your post notifications, because you don't have to miss me interviewing another child. Until then, signing off, this is Harsini and Yashwant here. Bye-bye. I'll see you next week.